ISO 9001 2015 process flow diagram and how to do that is what we're talking about in this video. I'm going to do a quick case study around powder coating and abrasive blasting because we've had a question here from our audience. So at any time you want to ask a question, send it through to us here at Best Practice TV. So in this video, we're talking about a process flow diagram and how to develop your own process flow diagram for your industry with a quick case study around abrasive blasting for your ISO 9001 2015 quality management system. We'll look at an integrated risk-based thinking as we take you through ISO 9001's process flow diagram. Okay, so we've been kicking some ideas around here. We've had a question around abrasive blasting and powder coating and how that can be mapped out in ISO 9001. Now, my first tip for you is keep it really simple. So I'm going to do that for you right now. It's a really simple process flow that moves through your organization with abrasive blasting and powder coating. So I want you to, while I'm doing this quick tip and keeping it simple, I want you to think about how would or what are the four basic steps that your organization follows. So you take a customer order, you specify the service, you prepare and deliver the service in your organization, and then you dispatch that service. So with powder coating and abrasive blasting, it's really basic and really simple. We've got marketing, and a subset to that marketing is the sales process, and I'm just gonna put it down here. And yes, it is important, we'll just pop it there. So marketing and sales. Then we've got customer order, and we'll just move through here. Customer order, we've got provide service, and then we've got what we call post-delivery activities or post-service activities. What are those? They are storage, transport, and then maintenance. So over here, we've got to always thinking with these processes, starting with the end in mind. So what are the post-service activities? What's the useful life? Now we are talking about powder coating. So powder coating typically over, you know, mild steel or stainless steel or aluminium or aluminum we call it aluminium here in Australia, but for you guys in the US, it's aluminum. So, and we're talking about powder coating. So abrasive blasting and powder coating in this instance. Now this is a generic process flow and I'm gonna apply it to just talking through the question that we've had around abrasive blasting and powder coating. So we'll do some marketing. Now, in your marketing materials, it's important to start to specify things like industry standards. And there's some science around abrasive blasting and powder coating. And so we want to be making sure that we're following that advice and the technical specifications. So we've got tech specs. Now, in my career, actually, for those of you that don't know, that my brother runs an abrasive blasting and powder coating facility. And I do know that you can do poor quality powder coating, and I know you can do high quality powder coating, just from my experience observing my brother's business, my brother's factory. So with your technical specifications and your industry standards, it's not just about, yes, it's really easy to apply powder coating over here at providing the service, but I have seen powder coating flake straight off within a couple of months. So we want to talk about the useful life. So what are we going to guarantee? So we're going to guarantee, say, 5 to 10 years, for example. And we want to start to think about that in terms of what we're doing at the front end. So we want to talk about guarantees or warranties. And we want to start to ask ourselves, if we're going to have warranties, what do we need to do in customer orders and provide services to ensure that we can meet our warranty commitments or our guarantees or the technical specifications? So this is where we'll do a process flow and we'll start to ask the questions. At each of these phases in our process flow, what do we need to do? So it's what, where, who, how, and when. And why is up here, because that's the stage. So it's why, what, when, who, how, and when, if that makes sense. And that's that plan, if you like, or what we would call controls. There's a bunch of other videos here on the YouTube channel about risk-based thinking in ISO 9001. Have a look at those other videos where I explain that in more detail. But for this exercise, we're just going to talk about making a plan to ensure that we can start with the end in mind, work through each of these stages. And our why is deliver amazing service. So amazing products and amazing service that our clients and our customers really love. So to do that, because then they'll refer work to us and we'll grow our business and we'll be having fun and we'll be really enjoying it. What, where, who, how, and when are the things that we need to do to deliver an amazing service at this stage? So marketing and sales, it's really important to be, you know, putting information out there on your website, in your brochures, on your counter, in your social media about all the things that you do, and that will frame up where you position yourself in the market. So it's what, you know, what's important. So in your marketing materials and your sales presentations and communications, talking about what's important. In customer service, it's all customer requirements. And if we talk about a quality project management, we talk about budget, time, and level of quality, if you like. So one, two, three, and those are the three categories. When we're starting with the end in mind, we're thinking about what's the customer's budget, and we're talking to them about the actual price of the work and a quote, if you like, the time, commitment, and promising the time that we're going to deliver it, and then the level of quality. Now, the level of quality does relate to the promises we made over here. So these are all of our promises. So what are the top six promises you make to your customers, either in your marketing material or your sales, around what you're going to do in terms of service? So have a think about when you're preparing your generic promises that you're going to make in your marketing materials or the standard script. Think about budget, think about time, and think about level of quality. Or there's a subset of this, which is performance. What level of performance in terms of quality does your customer expect? And that might be, you know, it might be a corrosive environment. It might be a, you know, we're here by the ocean here in Sydney, Australia, near Manly Beach. So it's a corrosive environment. Lots of salt comes through in the afternoon sea breezes. So all these buildings get corrosion. So corrosion protection and corrosion resistance really important here in these buildings that we're in, with all of the things that are being powder coated and painted. So performance, expected level of performance. So what does your customer expect? Did you talk about that? Now that might be an uncomfortable conversation, but it's important to have that uncomfortable conversation with your customer so that your customer can be educated on what a higher quality product is that will get the level of performance that they expect. And that might drive the cost in terms of the project. So what, where, who, how, and when are you going to have that conversation? Now then, in terms of providing the service, if those are the promises you made, that's the budget, time, and level of quality. What needs to happen over here? So what needs to happen, where, who, when, and obviously how. So that applies. So it's here as well. What, where, who, when, how. And the why is all about delivering an amazing service. So we want to transpose the marketing commitments, the promises, the agreement, into our service provision section, and this would be our powder coating factory, the saw abrasive blasting, the quality level of abrasive blasting that we're doing, the level of quality in terms of coating with the powder coating that we're doing, so that we can meet these commitments over the end based on the science and the policies and procedures and work instructions we've got. And this is, you know, this is abrasive blasting, it could be powder coating. And that was the case study we said we'd do, but it could be painting. It could be, you know, there could be issues with contamination. So it's all the things that become issues in providing the service to ensure that we can deliver our commitments. And then over here, you know, there's basic things like, you know, are our products going to get scratched? How are they stored? Are they going to get contaminated? Are they going to get mixed up? Are they going to get damaged? All that sort of stuff in terms of storage, transport, maintenance, and then obviously useful life. And again, you know, who is an important issue over here? Is it the customer's responsibility, or do you, is there an implied responsibility on you in terms of how the material gets packaged? If you're packaging up powder coating that's going to get sea freighted halfway around the world, then your packaging is going to be different to if it goes on a small truck that's going to go two blocks away. So we want to be thinking about that. Whose responsibility? What do they need to do? Where do they need to do it? Or where's it going? When? And obviously, how. So really basic process flow for an ISO 9001 system with risk-based thinking. What could go wrong? What are the sorts of issues we might have? What are the opportunities that we could pitch to our customer that are really going to set us apart and give them an outstanding service that they're going to love and good return on their investment? All those sorts of things can be considered at each of these process stages in your process flow diagram. So don't overcomplicate it. That's a document. So, you know, a lot of people can get too caught up in developing this and, you know, creating, you know, PowerPoint slide or Google Docs or Word documents to describe this. If you do it on a whiteboard, snap a photo of it, save that into your management system, you know, your shared drive. That's a really good example. If you do it really neatly on a whiteboard, take a photo of it with a smartphone, that's enough. You don't need to go and create it in a special document. That's a document right there. It's written down, it's captured, and it's version one. There you go. It's even version controlled. Our process flow diagram to deliver amazing customer service. Snap a picture of that, that'll do. If you need more help with this sort of stuff, comment below the video. Hit subscribe so you get all of the updates. We've got lots more of these. We're doing a couple a week of process flow diagrams, things on OH&S, things on environmental management, lots going on here at Best Practice TV. Check out my personal page on LinkedIn. So jump across onto LinkedIn. We'll put my handle in the comments below. You can follow me on LinkedIn. I do a couple of extra little LinkedIn videos a week. Now, if you really love this and you want more detail and more guidance on how to apply ISO 9001 or any of the ISO standards to your management system in your organization, we've got some great training courses that are fantastic, all available online in our training store. So we'll put the link to our training store below, and you can jump on and purchase one of those great courses where we'll take you step by step through the ISO standards and explain more of this in a lot more detail. And I'll see you right there in the Best Practice Training Academy, or right here if you subscribe. Hit the subscribe button above, right here on Best Practice TV. Bye for now.